Hello everybody, welcome back to Scratch for today, and today we are doing a little bit more programming, and today we are finally going to work at pipes. Oh yeah, what a horrible sound that was, but who cares. We're going to work on pipes. I haven't prepared anything at all, because I'm getting family over, my cousin is coming over, only thing I made is, in 2 seconds I made this texture right here. So what I chose to do is I chose to make a 32 by 32 area here. I like to have the sides, equal. It doesn't have to be, but I like to have it, because then you can have one variable, 32, which is basically the same for both of these, instead of having two variables. So if we launch up Minecraft here, we can see that I've been testing a little bit with the slabs here. Working like a charm. The only thing is, I can actually show you that, because that's probably soon coming up at my channel. So here you have two different, two exactly similar slabs. They are coded the exact way. They work, just like you'd think they'd work. The only thing here is that this right here, it doesn't drop. This is the black one. They're coded exactly the same, but that one drops. So yeah, they're coded exactly the same, uses exactly the same classes. They're only in two different mods. So I have no idea what's going on there. It is weird. I've never seen that before. But if we jump in here, yes, we have... Yeah, this is basically where I've tried out the slabs. What we've done is we have our windmill here. We just need some floor. We're going to kind of smooth this up a little bit later on here, probably. Make the model in the item instead. So right here we have the windmill. You can right click it and it kind of creates power. Now, what needs power? Well, we have in another mod here. We have a quartz furnace. I thought I had the macerator. Well, we need to update the macerator so that we can basically power the macerator using our cables. So what I'm basically thinking is you can basically hook up a cable to any part of this thing right here, and we should get to rendering the back of this as well. We'll be able to hook a pipe in here or at the bottom or something like that, and you can hook that over to the macerator, and it will kind of take the power from this thing right here. So first of all, we're not going to do that in a while. We're going to start off easily and simply by the blocks, and of course these are going to be custom rendered. So block pipe. There we go. This is basically going to be our pipe. Again, I haven't done anything at all to kind of set this up. But this block pipe right here. Now, first of all, it extends block container. The reason for that is because we need a We need a tile entity, so we're not going to grab material right here. We're just going to say material.ground. We're probably going to add a wrench later on. So create new tile entity. It's going to give us a world and a integer, which I have still not tried to figure out because there's no need. We're not going to use it. We're going to say though new tile entity and then pipe. Let's launch this up here. No, not import talented pipe. Let's create class talented pipe. This is from the steampunk mod. Spoilers. The mod I'm creating with Adexia here. But we have our pipe here. Now, before we get into anything else, connecting up the pipes and stuff like that, I'm going to explain this texture as well later on here, but we're going to start off by rendering this out. So what we're going to do, public static block. We've done this before, that's why I'm running quickly through it here. Creating a block pipe. Need to register it. Block pipe is equal to new block pipe. No arguments there. Set block name. We're going to set the block name to block pipe. We're going to set and then creative tab. We're not going to have a texture for this, so we're going to have a model rather than a texture. Block pipe. What I want to, yes, from netscreation.block. Pretty sure that's where we are in. Yes, we are. So we now have we now have our pipe. Now let's register this pipe here. Let's do it at the bottom. Block pipe. There we go. So we now have our block pipe in game. We also need to register the tile entity though. There we go. Pipe. Tile pipe from the Scratchfun mod. And we're going to just say pipe. Why not? That name's probably taken, but who cares? By another mod. I'm not sure if this is mod specific or not. But we won't care unless we get an error here. So, our block pipe is basically, you know, is basically creating this block tile entity pipe right here. Now, what we actually want to do is we want to head over to our client proxy. And we want to bind a special renderer tile entity pipe, tile entity, and then render pipe. So let's import and let's create class tile entity render pipe because we basically want to render our pipe. Not supposed to be in the proxy though, it is going to be in the tile entity render, and this is basically going to render out. Let's make it a little bit more clear what these stand for. This is basically going to be what's rendering out the pipes. Again, you can go for models here. I chose not to because tile entity. I chose not to go for these pipes. Basically, sorry, for these models. You can, you know, create a model and launch it up like that because we're going to have like connected textures basically. That's why I chose not. So basically, if you have this is basically how a normal pipe goes. It basically just, you know, if you have it connected like three in a row, the pipe in the middle will look like this. It'll just be one long kind of thingy. That sounds weird, but okay. If not, if it's like a bending area, then it's going to have like a core, and then with these at the side basically. So, that's all nice and easy. Let's just try to system.out.println to just make sure we didn't forget anything. YOLO here. And let's launch it up again. See whether or not it's managing to print out. There we go, we crashed. Add a mapping. Yeah, I thought it says duplicate ID. Pipe, I have another mod also with pipe, so let's go for mod ID plus, yeah, let's just go for something like that, okay? You should probably do that because this is not mod specific. I've always thought it was, but it doesn't seem to be. They should change that though. But we have our thingy now, it should be in our creative tab here. Doesn't look like it is. There we go. Block. This is basically our pipe right here. When we place it down, you probably can see it. Right here, it prints out YOLO, which basically means that it's trying to render. Let's close that off though while we are working a little bit here because we are going to just like. Let's just move a little bit here. There we go. Just like with we did with our windmill, we are going to make it the render type -1. We're going to set the OPQ cube to false and render as normal block to false. Okay. And this is basically going to make sure that it's not actually rendering anything that we kind of don't want it to render. So let's render this now. And it is launching up here. And now it should not render at all. There we go, it's not rendering at all. Now, of course, we're going to remove lighting and such. So while we're at it, let's just say this dot use neighbor brightness. Let's just set this to true. Hopefully that works. We're not going to close it off just yet, though. What we are going to do is we're going to jump in here. And we're going to start rendering. We can stop printing out yellow because we have checked this. We kind of need to render something in this thingy. And now it updated, no lighting kind of left in the block here. But we need to render out. we also need to set a block bounce less, but I'm going to have a 5x5 core. So we're going to draw out a core. To draw out a core, we're going to make a new method called public void draw core, okay? What this is going to do is it's only going to draw out the core. Now, for this we need a position to draw the core at. And this kind of position is basically going to be, because we have stuff like here. I think we can actually just say gl11.gl translate f, no, let's say translate d, and then translation x, translation y, and translation z. For those not who doesn't know what translation x, translation y, and translation z means, it basically is the position, or basically the distance between the block and the player. The player is kind of at 0, 0, and then basically off the point of rendering, the player stands at 0, 0, and then we'll kind of move this out. So it's not you moving around in a world, it's rather the world moving around you, basically. So let's draw the core here. Let's just pass over the tile entity while we're at it. Tile entity, we're probably not going to need too much of that. Let's also grab a texture here, so resource location. Texture is equal to new resource location. Location, and we're going to request for the mod ID, so scratchfun.modid, we're going to grab that. Did I grab the correct mod ID here? I don't think I did. Let's remove mod. I have two mods with the same kind of thing here. Yeah, it's called stuff, isn't it? There we go. I'm not sure why. Let's import resource location as well. So now basically grab the mod ID from our mod here, which is down at resources. It's going to jump in into Scratchfun here, and it's going to go into textures. No, it's not. We're going to have to tell it to go into textures, and then it is going. We're going to tell it to go into model. Okay, that's where I've saved the texture. Textures model, and it's under pipe.png. So let's do that. Textures. Make sure to spell this correctly, and then model, and then pipe. .png. Remember that you are required to kind of have the PNG at the end here. So textures, model, and then pipe.png. So that's the texture. What we kind of need to do now is we need to bind this texture. So this.bind texture, we're going to bind the texture, and then we're going to call a draw core, okay? To begin with, we're always going to draw the core, and then we're going to connect it later on here. But drawing the core is basically like we're going to start off by drawing out stuff, and then we're going to fix this later. So for those who are not for those who haven't done this before, didn't watch my series on the windmill, which is still not finished by the way, we are going to use a tessellator. Okay, now it's not as much tessellating as we did in the thingy, it's hard to like write correctly and talk at the same time and think at the same time, but it's not going to be too much tessellating. We're going to do tessellating 6 times to just draw out this right here. We're probably going to draw out the inside as well, as we're just going to invert that. That's very, very simple. So we're just going to draw this out 6 times basically, so it's quite simple. What we're going to have to say, we grab a instance of the tessellator, which is basically the drawer in Minecraft. So tessellator, and then we're going to say add vertex with UV. Then we're basically going to add a vertex, okay? So this is basically the position. Now, do note that the player stands at 0, 0. We have moved this already, so now our block kind of stands at 0, 0. So our block is 0, 0. And that's where we're going from. No, not our block, but the corner of our block. You can add plus 0.5 here as well, if you are really, really, if you, you know, can kind of rather enjoy that. But what we're going to do here is we're going to create a float, call it pixel, set it equal to 1 divided, 1 float, say float, divided by 16 float. And what that is basically going to give us is it's going to give us a 1 pixel. So if think that this is like whatchamacallit, this is a block right here. It is 16 pixels wide, and this float called pixel is now going to contain kind of the width of one pixel. So we can now kind of do this a little bit more specifically. Now, where are we kind of going to draw this out? Now, do note, I've said I made mine 5x5, and a block is 16x16, which basically means that you're going to have 11 pixels at the sides. So what we're basically going to have to say is 11 multiplied by pixel, which is 11 pixels in the side, divided by 2, is basically where we're going to start drawing this texture, okay? That's basically the distance between the beginning of the block till the start of our drawing. Now, where are we going to start drawing? I like to start drawing at the bottom right. So what we're going to say is we're going to say 1 minus. That's basically going to be at the right side of our our core here. Then we need to be at the bottom here as well. So what we're going to say here is actually just 11 pixels divided by 2, and to be set, I think let's just start, this is going to be the same for all of them, let's just start at 11 pixels divided by 2. Of course you can just write 7.5 or whatever it is. It's probably not 7.5, it's 5.5 or something. I'm not good at math, who cares? Who cares? Math is not my strong side, not talking and doing math at least. So we're going to have two arguments here. These are basically the position of the texture. So what we need to do is create yet another float here, which basically stands for the position of the texture. Kind of one is the width. If you write one at the float, it's basically out at the right here. If you write one at the height, it's down here. One at the width is here, basically. If you write 0.5, it's in the middle, you know, has the stuff like that. So we need basically to count all of the pixels. How much is a pixel if one is 32 pixels? So we're basically going to say texture, texture pixel, okay? The way you do this, one float divided by your width. I made my width and height the same. So it's basically going to be one pixel in height. It's the same as one pixel in width. That's why I made it this 32 by 32 as well. You can just crop it around here. It will work just the same if I did this like so. You would just say, okay, this is 21 wide divided by 21 float. There's your texture pixel. But then you have to say width because you kind of require another one for the height, which is 1 divided by 5. If we just say texture pixel here, it basically kind of is the same for the width and the height. So again, 32 float. Basically going to secure the position here. No, who cares? So we're going to start drawing out from the texture of the bottom right here. That's 5 pixels in from both sides. So what we're going to say is 5 pixels and 5 pixels. Okay, that's basically where we're starting to draw. Now, before we start drawing here, something I forgot. We need to tell it that we're drawing quads or, you know, squares, basically. So quads, what we're going to say is start drawing, you can say start drawing and GL11 underscore GL quad, or you can go for just start drawing quads, which is basically exactly the same. I like to open it up like so. This basically tells me everything in inside of these are drawing. These are not required, it's just for the looks. Looks of stuff. Now, at the end here, you need to say testLater.draw, or you're going to end up with a error saying that you've loaded the testLater too much, basically. Now, this has defined one point. We need 4 points. The next point, let's start with the texture starting down here, which is 5 pixels by 5 pixels. Then we're going to go to this point right here. You have to go counterclockwise, by the way, for this to kind of work. If you go the clockwise, that's clockwise, right? Yeah, I hope so. If you go clockwise, then you're going to end up with having the texture at the other side. But let's do this counterclockwise. We'll start right here. And then we're moving up to this position right here, which is basically 5 pixels in the width, 0 in the height. Then we move on down to this right here, which is 0, 0, 0 by 0. Right, just so you know, this is the width, this is the height. And then the final point is right here, which is basically 5 in the Y and 0 in the width. We're starting off with the width, which is 0, the height is 5. Quite simple. And now that that's done, we need to set the position of the point, and not only the texture. It's going to start at the bottom right, as I mentioned, so bottom right of the screen. Then we move up a little bit. So to move up, we are going to say 1 minus. That's all we need, because it kind of multiplies and divides before you do anything else. The next one, you say 1 minus. And then the last one is just like it stands. Now we need to change some of these as well. It starts here, then moves up here, and the third one, it's going to change the X, so the third one right here, it's not going to have the 1 minus anymore, and that's quite simple. So let's launch this up and have a look at how it looks. Right now we're basically just drawing the core. And we are quite long at time already. So if we move around, we can see there we go, that's our core. We draw it in a little bit of awkward position. Let's move it over. To move it over, change the set to all of these 1 minus. And that should change it over. It automatically updates. This is now at our side right here. It has lighting because it kind of objects lighting. So let's remove lighting. GL11.GL disable, and we can do GL11.GL_lighting. There we go. It's not lightning, it's lighting. Now do note that you probably have to enable this at the end here. So enable GL11 lighting. I always say lightning. Who knows? Who cares? So right now it shouldn't object to lighting. Should always be the same. Now, as you can see, this screws up over here. So that's something we need to be a little bit careful about. We can see that we tessellated. Let's why not tessellate back. This, I didn't thought that like mattered, but okay. So we have to tessellate back, save minus to kind of tessellate back to the original positions of translate D for double. And then you say negative X, negative Y, and negative Z as we move positive here. So that's basically back at the player position. And we're sadly going to have to end it right there. We've drawn one face. We're going to draw the five others as well. I'm going to set the block bound so it looks a little bit better. And basically I'll be back in the next episode, hopefully tomorrow, I'm not quite sure. I'm not going to be able to record anything with my cousin here, but I will do my best to kind of pre-record it a little bit. So yeah, thank you so much for watching, everybody. My name is Scratchman, and I'll catch you all guys in my next video. Goodbye, and have a nice day.